episode of Lopit. Today's discussion is regarding Juvenile Justice Act 2015. Recently, a juvenile who was accused of committing two murders was sent to Juvenile Justice Board in order to determine whether he should be treated as an adult or not. This action had to be taken in the light of new Juvenile Justice Act 2015, which came into effect from 1st January 2016. In today's discussion, let us consider the important provisions of the Act. One of the major changes that was brought in by the new Juvenile Justice Act is the provision which allows for treating juveniles as adults when the heinous crimes are alleged to have been committed by them. This provision was thought to be necessary as the heinous crimes committed by juveniles is on rise. However, this change in the law is applicable only on the juveniles who have committed heinous offence between the ages 16 to 18. Heinous offence has been defined by the Act as the one for which the punishment prescribed is more than 7 years. Thus, if a juvenile commits murder or rape between the ages 16 to 18, only then he will be tried as an adult. This Act, however, doesn't make this an objective rule. It is a subjective rule as the Juvenile Justice Board is given the discretion to assess as to whether the juvenile has to be treated as an adult or not. While exercising its discretion, the Juvenile Justice Board has to consider the three elements. Firstly, the mental and physical capacity of the juvenile to commit such an offence. Secondly, the ability to understand the consequences of the offence. Thirdly, the circumstances in which the offence was committed. After assessing these three elements, the Juvenile Justice Board can pass an order that there is a need to try the said child as an adult. After passing such order, the Juvenile Justice Board should pass the child to the child's court, where again the court has discretion to decide whether the child should be treated as an adult or not. Only if the child's court finds it necessary, then the child would be tried as an adult. In light of the above, it is safe to conclude that the new Juvenile Justice Act has sufficient safeguards to protect children from being treated as adults, and it is only in rare circumstances where the child would be treated as an adult. Thank you for watching us, and if you find this informative, then please do like and subscribe.